One day in a quiet town of celibacy, three young girls were eating their lunch. As they enjoyed their bologna and cheese sandwiches, they decided to share a bag of what they thought were ordinary salt and vinegar potato chips. Little did they know, an evil chip factory worker had added an extra ingredient, chemical B. Much to the surprise of the citizens of Celibacy City, this little-known and highly toxic chemical formed a strange bond with the DNA of the girls. And thus, the vigilante virgins were born. Cherry, Chastity, and Prudence. Regular high school freshmen by day, crime-fighting vigilante virgins by night. Working hard to keep the young people of Celibacy City from losing their virginity too soon.
Go vigilante virgins! Go vigilante virgins! They use their virgin power to fight off disease. With their super self-restraint, they combat pregnancy. They're the ultimate team for fighting virgin authority. They are virgins! Mega virgins! Vigilante virgins!
Late one night, Cherry, Chastity, and Prudence were working overtime on a science experiment for school. When suddenly...
Donald! Didn't you hear that?
I sure did! I wonder what that was.
I think it was the sound of someone in trouble!
Wait! I have an idea.
What is it?
Let's go help!
Cherry!
Chastity!
Prudence!
Virgin power!
Cuts my nose for me? I'm extra itchy today.
I wonder what Baron von Sibilis has cooked up for us today.
Step right us. Getting tired of trying to pick up chicks with YouTube tagging. No.
Sorry.
Yeah, sorry.
Hey, look, that thing over there. It's moving.
I wonder what it is.
I hope it's cheese.
Oh, there you are, my mischievous lad. What have you been doing with yourselves?
We were down by the docks trying to infect sailors, like you told us, Baron.
Excellent work.
It would have worked had this boobo not introduced us as the gonorrhea gang.
Yeah. I only did it once.
Once was enough, you twit. Now we'll have to wait for a new fleet to come in before we can go out looking for more unsuspecting sailors.
Yeah.
You would have been
silence! We do not have the luxury of arguing amongst ourselves when there are so many healthy people out there who must be infected. Now, gather round. Never mind. Stay where you are. Now listen up, my ghastly drumlights. I've hatched a new and depraved plan to spread sexually transmitted diseases to all the citizens of Selma City. Once this has been achieved, I will control the city, and then soon, the world! At which point, I can redecorate.
How are you going to do that, Baron?
Yeah, we've been trying for years to spread disease. Those blasted vigilante virgins keep foiling our plans.
Do not mention those brats to me again. They will not thwart this plan. This time we will strike when they are most vulnerable.
Where?
No, not there, you simpering fool. We will strike in their own backyard. Or schoolyard, as it were. Voila!
Hey, that's not cheese!
Of course not! This is Billy.
Hi, Billy.
We're going to infect Billy here with... Let me spell it out so he won't be so frightened.
STDs.
Then, Billy will go back to celibacy high school, where he will give it to all his little girlfriends, who will in turn unknowingly infect all their boyfriends, and so on, and so on, and so on.
Look! In the sky! It's the bee signal!
It seems like someone's being de-virginized!
Let's go help!
Thanks to the vigilante virgins, the town of Selma City was safe once again.
Billy made his way home without losing his virginity, and the girls finished their homework. And as night fell, all the citizens of Celibacy City were tucked away in their beds.
Conference. Doesn't give you the green light to act like monkeys.